writing my poems for the few that look at me, took to me, shook at me, feeling me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the...
Today, I will explain about moving observer method. Moving observer method is one of the methods to determine the journey speed and the running speed by conducting journey, time, and delay studies. In this method, the observer will move in a vehicle on the road that is known as the test vehicle. The test vehicle will flow in the traffic based on the specific flow, speed, and makes a round trip on the test section.
Take an example. The observer is traveling along with the traffic at 7 km per hour at 10 km road section. Assume the study is focused on a stream of vehicles moving to the east direction. The test vehicle will move towards east along with the traffic at 10 km and it will turn around towards west and move against traffic. The time taken for the test vehicle moving on the road section toward the east is referred as TW and to the west direction is referred as TA. There are three parameters that need to be observed in doing this method, which are the first one, the number of vehicle that overtook the test vehicle. Number two, the number of vehicle overtaken by the test vehicle. And lastly, number three, the number of vehicles traveling in the opposite direction.
For situation A, when the test vehicle overtook any other vehicles in the test section along with the traffic, it is referred as Y1 East. While for situation B, when any other vehicles overtook the test vehicle, it will be known as Y2 East. When the test vehicle start to turn around towards west, each of the vehicle that counter the test vehicle will be observed. By using all parameters that have been given, we can obtain three data, which are the volume in each direction, the average travel time, and the average journey speed.
A situation where the test vehicle is overtaking another vehicle and the number of vehicle that had been overtook is recorded and represented as Y2 is in the formula. Where the other vehicle is overtaking the test vehicle and the number of overtaking vehicle is recorded and represented as Y1 is in the formula. And where the test vehicle is heading toward west and the number of vehicle headed toward east is also being recorded. In all three situations, the time taken must be recorded.
At one road section, 35% of the vehicles traveling at 65 km per hour, 35% of the vehicles traveling at 85 km per hour, and the rest traveling at 110 km per hour. The observer was traveling with the traffic at 80 km per hour at 6 km road section. The test vehicle was overtaken by 18 more vehicles than he can overtake. When the test vehicle moved against the traffic, he encountered 300 vehicles in the opposite direction. Okay, determine the traffic flow and the average travel time. And the second one, the number of vehicles traveling at 100 km per hour. First question is about the traffic flow. Okay, as we know, the formula of the traffic flow is Q sub is equal to X sub is plus Y1 sub y sub 1 is minus y sub 2 is divided by t sub a plus t sub w. Okay, as we can see from the question, x sub is represent the number of vehicles that the test vehicle encountered during the opposite direction. So x1 is 300 vehicles. So for y1 is the number of vehicle that was overtaken, and the y2 is the number of vehicle that the test vehicle can overtake. So we assuming that y1 is minus y2 is equal to 18. Okay, so the time travel for the test vehicle, as we know, he can take at 6 km per section with the speed of 18 km per hour. So if we divided the distance and the speed, we can get the time travel for the test vehicle. So to get the traffic flow using this formula, you can get 2120 vehicle per hour for the traffic flow. Okay, next about the average travel time. The formula is T sub is equal to T sub W minus Y sub 1 is minus Y2 sub is divided by Q sub is. Okay, T sub W we have get here 0.075 per hour. 0.075 hour. So y1 is and y2 is we get here 18, and q sub is we get earlier 2120 vehicle per hour. So if we insert the value in the formula, so we get the t sub is equal to 0.0665 per hour, or equivalent to 4 minutes. Question: the number of vehicles traveling at 110 km per hour. Okay, as we can see, from here 35% is 65 km per hour, 35% 85 km per hour. So the remaining is 30% for 110 km per hour. Okay, so now we want to know the number of vehicles traveling at 110 km per hour. We can use this equation. So the number of vehicle is equivalent to Q sub V multiplied by T sub W minus T sub V. Okay, Q sub V is the proportion or percentage of the vehicle multiplied by the Q sub is, which is 2120. So we get 636 vehicle per hour for the Q sub V. Okay, so now we want to determine the T sub V. Okay, T sub V is equivalent to the distance of the road section divided by the speed. So we get 0.0545 hour. So insert the value from the calculation, we can get the number of vehicles traveling at 110 km per hour is 13 vehicles. Thank you.